Welcome back, viewers, to understand the definition of tort. Because tort has no scientific meaning, as a matter of fact, it is an ever-growing branch of law and has constantly developed, and the area covered its ambit is continuously increasing. Anyhow, some definitions of tort is much more essential for the understanding of this subject. Some of the important definitions which indicate the nature of this branch of law are as: tort means a civil wrong which is not exclusively a breach of contract or breach of trust. It is mentioned in Limitation Act 1963, Section 2M. Solomon defined like this: it is a civil wrong for which the remedy is a common law action for unliquidated damages, and which is not exclusively the breach of a contract or a breach of a trust or other merely equitable obligation. Winfield defined tort as: tortious liability arises from the breach of a duty primarily fixed by the law. This duty is towards person generally, and its breach is redressable by an action for unliquidated damages. According to Frosher, it is an infringement of a right in realm of a private individual, giving a right of compensation at the suit of the injured party. The basic idea which is indicated by this definition is, firstly, tort is a civil wrong, and the second one defines every civil wrong is not a tort. There are other civil wrongs also, the important of which are a breach of contract and breach of trust. No such scientific definition of tort has been possible which could explain this wrong by mentioning various elements, the presence of which could be considered to be a tort. The various definitions which have been attempted try to follow a negative approach. They explain the nature of tort by either distinguishing it from other wrongs or by mentioning some of the elements which are found in a tort but are not there in other wrongs. When some wrongful act has been done, it has got to be seen first whether it is civil or a criminal wrong. If the wrong is found to be a civil one, we have to see whether it exclusively belongs to any other recognized category of civil wrong, like breach of contract and breach of trust. If we find that it is not exclusively any of the other civil wrongs, then we can say that it is a tort. However, the term is found in common law system for a civilly actionable harm or wrong, and for the branch of law dealing with liability for such wrongs. Analytically, the law of tort is a branch of the law of obligations, where the law obligates to refrain from harm to another, and if harm is done, to repair it or compensate for it, or imposed not by agreement but independently of agreement by force of the general law. Socially, the functions of tort is to shift loss sustained by one to the person who is deemed to have caused it or being responsible for its happening, and in some measures to spread the loss over an enterprise or even the whole community. Historically, there was no general principles of tortious liability but the king's court gave remedies for various forms of trespass, for direct injuries, and later allowed an action on the case for harm indirectly caused. Other form of harm later became redressable, example, libel and slander, and distinct form of action developed to redress particular kind of harm, so that the law of tort was concerned with a number of recognized kinds of wrong, each with distinct requirements and procedure. Statute added new entitlements to claim, example, in case of fatal accidents, and a new grounds of liability. Case law has extended liability, example, from physical injuries to mental injuries, and from intentional harm to harms done negligently. That is, by failure to show the standard of precautions deemed necessary in the circumstances. It remains the case, however, that the law of tort is a collection of circumstances in which the courts will give a remedy, normally by way of damages, for legally unjustified harm or injury done by one person to another, rather than a general principles of liability applicable to manifold cases. It is potentially confusing to think of tort as connected with wrongs, as a wrongful element consists only in there having been a breach of legal duty, which may be purely technical and not involve any moral delinquency or criminality. Tort or crime sprang from a common root but have divergent in many respects, but it is still true that many common law crimes are also actionably torts, example, assault, but not conversely. Liability in general depends on the defendant having, by act or omission, acted in breach of a legal duty incumbent on him and infringed a recognized legal right vested in the plaintiff, and thereby caused the plaintiff harm of a foreseeable kind. Not every harm is actionable. There is no liability for an inevitable accident or an act of God. There are justifications such as statutory or common law authority. The pecuniary consequence of liability may be shifted by liability insurance.